Hey guys, it's C-Drama Invasion here. Welcome back to a new video, and today we're on episode 6 of my latest series where I report Chinese drama news, updates, and focus on a couple of my favorite actors and actresses and their recent news the previous couple of weeks. If you're new to my channel, or if you haven't checked out the rest of the episodes, I'll leave a playlist down below in the description box so you can check out the previous episodes. I'll also put links down below for all of my other types of videos, such as top 10 Asian drama videos, 2 in-detailed biography videos or facts and profile videos of Chinese actors and actresses. Make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. It really does help out my channel, and comment something down below. And also, I'll leave names to all of the dramas or movies I've listed in the description box as well. Make sure to subscribe and turn on that notification bell to all so you don't miss out on future videos. Anyways, let's just jump on into it. So today we have quite a couple of news for fans of GoGo Squid, such as myself. I'm extremely excited to report to you that Yangzi is reuniting with Li Xian again. However, first let's talk about Li Xian's birthday this year and how the two co-stars interacted with each other online. So a very sweet and nice interaction between them. This was on October 19th, which was on Li Xian's birthday. He turned 29 this year. His most recent drama is Sword Dynasty. And on his birthday, Yangzi wishes Li Xian a happy birthday by reposting last year's post of her birthday wishes to him. She added an extra statement which says, "Another year, old classmate. Happy birthday. Continue walking on that flower road," which in translation, flower road basically means success and happiness and wellness all around. So he quickly responded to her post by saying, "Thank you, sister. You also stay well." It seems that these two are still quite good friends in real life, and I'm happy to say that seems like Yangzi and Li Xian fans are not only getting one reunion next year for their GoGo Squid cameo in Apple Dogs Time or in GoGo Squid 2, but they're also reuniting in one of Li Xian's upcoming movies, which is supposed to come out on December 5th of 2020. So although nothing was announced, a very sharp-eyed fan spotted her in the poster of his upcoming movies. She's in the background and it's super blurry, but I'll leave a photo on screen for you to see. She is dressed up in a historical drama type of costume, and she looks a lot like her character from Ashes of Love. I'm so excited, even if it's just a small cameo, and I'm looking forward to this movie even more. This movie is called Red Fox Scholar, or it's also known as Soul Snatcher according to some sources, and it depends on the translation. This is an upcoming movie that is coming out on December 5th, 2020. This seems to be a bromance, historical comedy, fantasy movie. This movie is about a fox spirit played by Li Xian's character, who has to disguise as a young man and travel around the human world to find a divine pill. There, he becomes super close friends with a scholar man who is played by Chen Li Nong. This seems super fun, and if you're into bromance and adventure, definitely check this out when it does come out. Now let's move on to Love is Sweet co-star news. Bai Yu and Liu Yunxi recently both attended the Love is Sweet fan meeting to promote their drama. They shared quite a lot of cute photos together and even reenacted some of the scenes and got back into characters and their roles in Love is Sweet. But one news that stood out in particular is that how they both expressed that they want to work together again, and especially on a historical drama with each other. During the fan meet for Love is Sweet, this happened on October 24th, both of them said that they want to work on a historical drama where the characters are strong and they're able to fight each other, basically. I can definitely imagine that, and that would look so good. I'm imagining his character from Ashes of Love versus her character in The Legends right now, and they would be great together. And if not, they both express their feelings to work on a variety of different genres of dramas together. So Bailu says that she wants to act in a doctor role or a medical role. I would definitely love to see them in a medical drama, even though I don't watch too many myself, but I can definitely picture them wearing that white medical coat and rocking it. On the other hand, Leo says that he wants to work on a suspense role or a role with more mystery and drama. Hopefully that this means it won't be the last time we get to see them on screen together. I definitely like this pairing, and if it does come true, which one of these genres would you want to see them in the most? Let me know down in the comments below. The last two pieces of news are some upcoming drama news. The first one stars Darren Chen and Zhang Yisheng in an upcoming Xianxia drama called Yu Zhaoling. There's no official English translation yet, but there is character posters that have been released for this drama. This is a story that follows an upright goddess and a constable with a cold exterior who join hands to solve a crime and find love along the way. There will be themes of immortals, goddesses, demons, ghosts, and things like that. It sounds really good, and the photo right here reminds me so much of the drama The Legends with Bai Lu and Shu Kai. Hopefully it will be just as good. There's no news on whether or not this will air this year or next year, but the fact that we're getting character posters might mean that this will come sooner than later, and hopefully that is the case. And last but definitely not least is that there is news for the web drama The Romance of Huarong Season 2. It recently started filming, and both leads are confirmed to come back for the next season. This drama stars Yuan Hao and Zhao Zhao Yi. The first season follows a pirate king that ends up marrying the female lead, and this is kind of a forced marriage. Eventually, she escapes the island, and last season there was a love triangle involved, as well as some politics aspects. And this season, I believe they are dealing with a neighboring country that might start a war. But I hope things are still as cute and light as the first season, or they can mix it up. But as long as it's balanced, then I'm happy. I love these two together, and their chemistry is off the charts. If you need a quick and fun historical drama to watch and you haven't already seen it, make sure to check it out. That is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below which of these dramas you're most excited for and your thoughts and feelings. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Check out all the links down in the description box below for a ton of other videos related to Chinese dramas. And I'll see you next time. Bye.